Blackstone Audio presents Lisbon, War in the Shadows of the City of Light, 1939 to 1945, by Neill Lochery. This book is read by Robin Sachs. For Emma, Benjamin, and Helena. Introduction. At the end of the movie Casablanca, as Rick Blaine and Captain Louis Renault head off to start their beautiful friendship by joining the Free French garrison at Brazzaville, the plane carrying Victor Laszlo and Ilse Lund takes off into the fog. It is to neutral Lisbon that they are headed with their letters of transit. In real life, the city of Lisbon during World War II more than resembled the film set. To many people who worked in the city during the latter stages of the war, Lisbon became affectionately known as Casablanca II. The real-life version had all the ingredients of the fictional storyline. Broken romances, desperate refugees trying to obtain the correct paperwork and selling the family jewels to finance their onward passage, a thriving black market as supply dictated that the prices of diamonds and other rare stones fell to record low levels. Cafes and hotel bars full of refugees and spies scattered across the city centre and along Lisbon's coastline resorts. There was also a real-life Captain Renault in Lisbon, the greatly feared head of the Portuguese secret police, Captain Agostinho Lourenço. Senior figures of the German Reichsbank were in the city from time to time, busy arranging payment terms for Portuguese goods. The city had the last great gambling house in wartime Europe, located along its coastline at Estoril. Here, the roulette wheel was spun long into the night, with the exiled royalty of much of Europe playing blackjack at the tables, or engaged in private sessions of poker in the discreet side rooms. It was here that wealthy Jewish refugees gambled against suntanned German Gestapo agents dressed in badly cut civilian clothes, with the house taking 5% of everybody's winnings. During the years of World War II, Lisbon was at the very center of world attention and was the only European city where both the Allies and the Axis powers openly operated. Lisbon's story was set within the context of a country that was frantically trying to hold on to its self-proclaimed wartime neutrality, but which, in reality, was increasingly caught in the middle of the economic and naval wars between the Allies and the Nazis. It was not, however, a conventional tale of World War II. Barely a shot was fired, or a bomb dropped. Instead, it was a tale of intrigue, betrayal, opportunism, and double dealing. All of which took place in the Cidade da Luz, City of Light, and along its idyllic Atlantic coastline. Ultimately, a relatively poor European country not only survived the war physically intact, but came out at the end of it in 1945 much wealthier than it had been when war had broken out in 1939. Although much of this wealth was considered by the Allies to be ill-gotten gains, the Portuguese were allowed to retain the vast majority of it as post-1945 Cold War political realities re-emphasized the importance of the country and its Atlantic islands, the Azores, to the cause of the Western powers. Lisbon was a city in which an apparent German plot to kidnap the Duke and Duchess of Windsor was foiled. They were among the more exotic refugees, many of them Jewish, who flooded into the city seeking a passage to the United States or Palestine on one of the ships that sailed from the neutral port, or for the super-rich, via the Azores on the Pan-American Boeing Clipper flying boat service to New York. Most refugees, however, had to wait months or even years in the city before securing their onward passage. On the run from the Germans since the fall of France in the summer of 1940, many of the refugees survived on a clandestine network of financial and organizational support, which originated from the offices of wealthy American Jews in New York City. The not-so-fortunate had to rely on the limited help from the British, the Portuguese authorities, and locally run rescue organizations. Allied and German agents operated openly in the city and monitored every move of the enemy. Their role was to log enemy shipping movements in and around the busy deep-water port of Lisbon, to spread propaganda and to disrupt the supply of vital goods to the enemy. Among the agents who visited Lisbon was a young Ian Fleming, busy devising Operation Goldeneye and playing blackjack at the Estoril Casino, a location that was to later provide the inspiration for a James Bond film. The Iberian desk of the British Special Operations.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.